name is Mr. Harit Mohan, who's founder and CEO of Clapping Afterwards. Okay, let me first complete it. Who's founder and CEO of Signicent LLP India and Signicent LLC in Denmark, USA. The company employs more than 20 full-time experts in the area of IPR. To elaborate more, means patents, how to do patents, trademarks and copyrights. As an IIT Madras 2008 postgraduate, research in technology has always been close to his heart. He has also done courses on entrepreneurship, launching an innovative business from University of Maryland. He has taken 12 years of his career solving problems and overcoming hurdles faced by research companies and different institutes. His company has been a technology IPR consultant to over 400 plus businesses globally spread across 15 countries. So pilots. He has been a member of different other organizations which include PIUG, LES, CIP, II, PhD Chamber, etc. India. So with that, I welcome Mr. Harit Mohan for this special talk.
Too early. something better is gonna come to us, so let's party. And so we went to a kind of a dinner place, a restaurant that afternoon. We had food for dinner, and the company was so smart that company never made us came in, and they just emailed us our flight tickets back to our home cities. Okay, so we came back home. And then what happened was that this was like Diwali time.
I'm talking about a typical service.
need laptops, you need to pay your employees that you have, and of course you are still burning and you still have not no income incoming. So I started off with my second startup, and that was for my work from home. So I started writing research articles for US people. Okay, I used to charge them $10 a page. I did it for about 6 months, collected my funds good enough to, you know, register a company. And then once again, third time I started it off with Signicent, which is now about 7 years old, and I'm standing in front of you for running this. We are doing about, we have now 80 full-time experts with us. We have two offices, one in US, one in India. And we are doing decently well on the fastest growing in India. Okay. So the story is, you never know whether it is gonna happen. If it is gonna happen, the only thing is, and my motive to give you this drugs of the to give you an idea, if this happens, what should be the first steps you should be able to know? Alright? So let's start with it, and I will of course share some of the good stories in between. First question, and very important question. How many of you think for the first question what you should do? Good paid first job or a startup?
Startup.
Alright. How much is your monthly budget that you currently spending from your pocket or from your parents' pocket? What do you get when you call it from your
2000?
Okay. What's the average size? 2000, 2000, 5000? Anybody below 5000 or somebody above 5000 as well? Okay, so no high middle. What are the first steps to launch a startup? That's the second question we will try and answer today. If you want to do it, how you should do it? So keep it more practical. Third question that you will answer is, how much money do I need? I've answered that, but it would be highly dependent and highly variable in the kind of business you want to try. And the fourth is the most important question we have to do. What will my girlfriend or boyfriend think about it? Because the reality is, most of you will not be earning much money as compared to the job. What's the average package that you get in the average, not the highest or not the lowest? 6-7-5-8-6-6-ish, roughly about that. Okay. So if that's what you are aspiring at, that you think you are going to earn $20 per month initially, so what you would be cutting down is a minus $50,000 per month. If you are okay with it, then probably this is what you should be thinking about right now. Because initially startup is all about consuming efforts, money, and lots of patience. And then the risk that may fail is too high. How much of startups in India face? There is a reason behind it. Why such amount of startups are failing? What does India rank now in the startup scale? We rank number 3. Right after US, UN, UK right now in startups. So one, there are a lot of startups happening, people are passionate about it. Two, the risk of failing is way too high. 95% means if all of us will try, maybe the only the first 2 men should take it. And all other who end up losing money, losing time, losing the jobs they would have got in other ways. So how do you then kind of, you know, understand that, how can you decrease the risk of those failures? What I have realized is one thing that will definitely need is good mentorship. People who have walked that path before, please be in touch with them. They will help you not do those errors that they would have done, or I would have done, or you guys may do when you start. So networking and mentorship is first and foremost thing. You have, you know, that in contact when you want to start. So the biggest definitions for entrepreneurs says that they have to be inventor and opportunist to make it. But I kind of molded it when I started it off. The first question that I was solving as an entrepreneur is, I have a 400, I mean my first office was maybe about were lucky people. At that time, there were no incubations possible. So that kind of would help you save your first initial bills. That, you know, the incubation center would take the cost. The second important thing that I want to tell you is that when you start up, you are not too shy about anything. I have, for example, done almost every task from signing agreements between companies to travel to, you know, sleepless nights, which was about 48 hours in stretch sometimes. And most importantly, if required, my office boy was not there, I was also swiping my own office for cleaning it, because the next day the office people will come in. And I was blessed to have some very good staff. Kushal is with me, he's there with me for about 6 years. Kushal, raise your hand. So he's there for the last 6 years with us currently. Last 6 years is still working with me. He kept his faith on the company and me. And that's why, you know, we have reached at the point where we are. So when we summed it up, I found the person need to be founder, a visionary, a technical person, a marketing person, an HR person, an admin person. He need to be an accountant. He need to learn accountancy also. He should be a lawyer of sort. He should know marketing. He should also know IT. And if required, he need to also become an office boy. All in all, you need a chalta chalta super passion. That's what, you know, entrepreneur in real life becomes. If you want to choose this path, you may not say, you know, we are engineers. How do we care what is happening in income tax? Because the minute you will start thinking that, you will be fooled by somebody. And do you have money to pay for all those 12 jobs at a single time initially? No. No. Because each of them would expect a salary of 20,000 initially, and there are about 12 jobs. So per month you're burning 2.5 lakhs, which is not possible as a serial startup. So to cut that money out, you need to start learning it. I learned website development from YouTube, and I kept getting to 12 se 3 draft of website development and just to create the first draft of a website. And I was a biotech person. I had moved to IT. And the same will be for electrical engineers who have no clue of their IT things. So there are some things that you need to do. Have you heard of the famous saying, Jack of all, master of none? How many of you agree with it? In a good sense or in a bad sense? So is it good to be Jack of all and master of none? Or is it bad to be Jack of all and master of none? So the definition that I have given below, I think Jack of all is what you need to become, and master of some is also important, because that's the line that you're going to do business in. Right? So we will start off with, and these are some of the things we created. So we did a quick survey. I'm also running a entrepreneurship program for class 9 to 12 by TIE. Have you heard about TIE? So TIE, we are picking up students of class 9 to 12 from schools in Tri-City. We have picked about 70 students from class 9 to 12. They are actually being taken up on a business training for the next 6 months. I am one of the steering committee members. Together we are making them make a business plan, want to prepare a pitch for it. The Chandigarh finalist will be going to US for about $15,000. That's about 10 lakhs in cash price after December this year. So it's all happening. Students, for those who think it's too early, class 9 to 12 people are already doing it with us. So it may not be too early already for your guys. Okay? So any of these things that you think you're not good at, what is the biggest challenge on this slide that you feel will be there when you're starting up? Anybody afraid of this? What is the biggest doubt? Anybody afraid of these two things? Okay. All of this will actually come in very handy. I still remember, I'm very, what should I say? मैं बहुत बदनाम हूँ कि फैमिली में फॉर रीचिंग ऑन पार्टीज विच आर are talking to friends, and sometimes it's my birthday and I am hosting them till late. Okay, so this happens. Why? Because you have a call from United States at 7:30 because that's the time US opens up. And several of times it has happened that I parked cars in petrol pump hours. I don't know where not to take my client calls. To address that, my business needs are also intact, because every time you think, you know, you're working for about a year, you finally get a lead, you don't want to ruin it out. Even if it is a special day, even if it is a sleep day, you cannot just get lazy at all, at no point of time. The minute you start decreasing your fuel, the minute you will think your entire company is, you know, running down the race. Right? So there are three important steps that you will talk through this presentation. The first thing is you need to have a good idea where you want to set up. The second thing is you need to protect that good idea so that others cannot copy. The third thing is once all the first two steps are done, then you can start up on your own. So much of your entrepreneurship, two important things come up: the problem that you are solving, how to protect, the solution that you have find out so that no other can copy. Third thing is, once everything is done, start up on your own. How many of you think budget is an important constraint when you start up? Paise nahi milte. Even if you have good ideas, lot of you. Do you think managing or getting about 10 lakhs is difficult thing in today's scenario? Yes, no. Raise hand for people who think 10 lakhs initial seed funding is difficult to get. That's why we are crashing. Difficult? Okay. Others, it's doable? Not doable? Okay. How many of you think it's doable? 10 lakhs is easy to get. Others? Others will just watch it and enjoy it. Then please, if they fail or if they succeed. So for the people who say 10 lakhs is easy to get, what's your initial source? Can I say login?
Investors, they will connect you. But my problem is, if your parents have not trusted you, investors will
research for that domain. So it is more possible to convince.
I will ask you that. What is the right time to ask for investment, investors' money? Of course, there is no right time or wrong time, but let's have this math very clear. Initially, when you launch up a company, this is the 100% of your company. Right? Let's assume this is the 100% of your company. How much of this would be divided into the partners? Let's say there are three founders in the company, founder and two co-founders, will make it 33% each. Right? Depending upon the funds you will ask, they may actually end up having the control of your own company. The earlier you ask, the more less is the value of your company, the more they will end up having it, and later on you will regret it. Who are the owners of Flipkart? Who are the founders of Flipkart? Why have both quitted already?
Because they are running their own startup and investing on other
side. No, because they ran out of their shares raising funds. They wanted to run money into their business so that they can keep continuing propelling in the same growth. And at the end of the day, they have almost nothing left. Given away. Flipkart, which was started by the founders are no more in the company right now. The reason is they gave 10%, 30%, 40%, 30%. They have raised so much funds that they have nothing left now to even give the shares, and then you know, Walmart came and had everything else. So this is very important. How much funds you need to actually kill a share or kill a part of your company, which will not be your own then. It will be theirs. So to negotiate it, if you come to as a kid to me, I would say that 5 lakh ke liye bhi, you would have to fight with me. I may ask for 40% of your shares initially to give you 10 lakhs. But is it worth it? You need to decide that. Some people say 60% of crore is more than 100% of zero. Because if they're not gonna do it, it's 100% of zero, it's not gonna go anywhere. So that's also true. So you need to balance it out. My suggestion is, take it to the point with your own money. Bootstrapping is the word. When you put in your own money, put in your friends and family's money to bootstrap it. Bootstrapping is always important. And as you go in for longer time, then you start asking for investment if needed. Try to self-sustain it for as long as possible, especially if you are not into business and are already popular. What Uber did? What Ola did? What Uber did initially? If you want to use Uber, right? और आप उसी राइड के लिए कितना दे रहे हो? 5 times, 4 times, 3 times of the initial amount, right? So what happened was, like you were saying, some investors would have invested, let's say, $1 million at that time, and they were distributing you. The minute that investments start running out, they need to become profitable, and then they started asking their customers. Jio, what they did was a typical example of this. 3 months free. They penetrated into the market. Make you habitual. They of course would have done calculations. Okay, you know, if you put a lot of money in here, the 20% of our market will not with us, but will end up, you know, staying 70% of it. So that's what Jio also did. So when you get money, you acquire customers. The minute money rents out, you need to still become self-sustainable. If you don't become self-sustainable, what do you do? You end up getting, selling yourself. Have you heard about Uber's competitor in China? Who is Uber's competitor in China? Who is in India? Who is Uber's competitor in China? Charges at all. Neither they were taking commissions from drivers, nor they were charging their customers. 6 months or 5 months in Chinese were very happy. 6 months mein, they have won $2 billion, huge money of investors. Money is burned out. Then, when the actual war time was coming in, Uber announced we are raising another $3 billion to continue this war so that we can, you know, compete with Didi. Didi said, fine, go ahead, raise $3 billion. We already have $20 billion lined up. For all of you want to play this game. Uber gave up in China. They ended up selling the company to Didi, which was their competitor. So that's how, you know, it goes. Money is important. You need to have good cash. No, you will need it all the time. In India, however, the case has reversed. Probably Ola was never backed by some strong investor that they could have moved out to a property, but they did it very successfully in China. So that's why the investment is important. But they were, you know, burning on the shares basically. So let's, you know, quickly understand well-defined problem statements. Have you ever thought of starting up in some area? Is it a big idea? Want to start up in some area? Not yet? Yeah, you have. What's your idea? You want to share it? No, no problem. Good. So, what you need to check is, the second important thing is novelty. Am I the first one to do it? Or are there any models that are, you know, lying out there? The product viability, the application, what the competitor are looking like, my market readiness, have I done, you know, sufficient experimentation, and then how will I diffuse or implement my idea to the people to make it commercialized.
So having said that, you need to, you know, kind of check. How many of you heard about Google Scholar already?
mistake in your thesis, in your projects, if you are not taking good patents. Because the most inventive search would be coming into patents, and people will not put into research articles or research journals. So that's there, and then you need to identify. So I'm giving you something very important today. Let's say when you are starting up, you identify that I want to solve seven problems, and this could also work for your projects. And there are six solutions possible for it. Correct? So when you are searching on Google Scholar, Google Talent, every time that you get, you know, one particular reference or a paper or a patent, do a plus one in that combination. So what you would see is, slowly you would see that I have a density map available with me, where I would know where the radius or where the area of the circle is proportional to the number of solutions that are already known to solve that problem. If you would do that, would you now like to invest when you are starting in this area? No. Simple reason is there are too many. Would you like to put your thesis in that area? No, because you know there are too many. So the area that you want to work is the thinner areas, which is we call as white space analysis. The area which are more white and not dark is where you would invest. That's how you pick up your startup problem. That's how you should pick up your research problems that you would be solving in your area. So we exercise. Have you heard about this stuff? Yes. Heard about it? What are cartons? Yeah, just a tip, like you know, खराब हो जाएगी, किसी से ताने सुनेगी, सही है. सो समबडी सम टू स्टूडेंट्स इन हैदराबाद टू पिस्ड ऑफ टेलिंग दिस व्हाट इज इट वाज दे पुट अप अ इंफ्रारेड सेंसर इन फ्रंट ऑफ टीवी सो द मिनट द डिस्टेंस कम लेस देन 2 3 मीटर्स द टीवी इज स्विच ऑफ एज सच लाइक दैट करेक्ट प्रॉब्लम कॉमन डे प्रॉब्लम एंड अ कॉमन डे सॉल्यूशन अनदर स्टूडेंट वाज दैट इट वाज कम्युनिकेटर आस्क्ड जब आप कॉलेज में आए थे 12th का पेपर के व्हाट नेक्स्ट क्या करना है अगला ये तो हो गया व्हाट नेक्स्ट ऑल योर व्हाट इज क्वेश्चन व्हाट नेक्स्ट इन योर लाइफ सो दिस स्कूल ग्रुप स्टूडेंट्स व्हाट इज व्हाट वाज दे मेड अ व्हाट नेक्स्ट ऐप वेयर दे कनेक्टेड द स्टूडेंट्स फ्रॉम क्लासेस एंड द मेंटर्स दैट आर देयर टू क्लब इन एंड सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम ऑफ व्हाट नेक्स्ट सो माय आईडिया इज स्टार्टअप्स कम फ्रॉम कॉमन डेज प्रॉब्लम दे नीड नॉट टू बी मल्टी बिलियन डॉलर प्रॉब्लम दैट यू आर सॉल्विंग इनिशियल प्रॉब्लम इनिशियल सॉल्यूशन शुड बी वेरी चीप very easy to do and should have a major market. Alright. What are trademarks? Trademarks are logos. If I say a jingle ting ting ting, which brand it is? Have you heard ting ting ting? Britannia. I didn't know Britannia name, so how you guessed it? That's the power of trademarks. So you recall, if I say I am loving it, that's the power of brands, that's the power of trademark. When you build up a company, you need to make sure you get such a good name and you promote it so well so that your audience and customers can stay for it. What are copyrights? What are copyrights? Koi shayar hai?
The biggest bluff makers are the colleges and universities who run
say we will give you 10,000 cash price and just like that. We'll give you 1 lakh, the minute rate 1 lakh. And who are the jury people, the big industrialists who have money right now, who are just stars of ideas? They have money, all they need is some good idea. You will get 10,000 and 10,000 exchange yourself, sold a very quick idea to them. So should you stop going to this competition? No. File an IP before it. File a patent. I got a call, I got two calls right away. I'll tell you, one of my friends from IIT, he was working on a robotic device. Okay, so he created a robotic device. He was working with a Pune-based company, Indoor. And he was also fond of robotics. And he made a robotic device. So what did it was, he tried to sell support. It didn't work out for the next 2-3 years. He kind of gave up on robotics and he thought, fine, I'll do the job itself. I'll not go to robotics at all now. What happened was, 5 years down the line, he got a call from Flipkart saying you're interested in buying the technology that you have built. Why don't you come here for the demo? He called me a buyer seller. I said, product leke jayega, they will say no. Anyhow, they will know what your technology is and they will make it. Flipkart has like millions of dollars with it. The only thing that can protect small investors, small inventors, small startups are their IP. Nothing else can protect you guys. So it's very important that you should have IP before you start pitching your ideas. Okay? And then you can either sell or license the IP. So first is research, then you protect your IP, then you disclose the idea, evaluate it in the market, and then you write. This is the last few slides. So this is what I did. So this is what I did when I started off my company. The first thing is name your company. Check the domain name availability. Go to godaddy.com. Have you heard about it? Okay. So whatever names you are having for your company, check for a .com and not .in, .net, .in, .in. Check for .com straight away. Try to keep it short, less than 10 alphabets at a time. And challenges is, jab aap sochoge, you will not be able to find a domain name which is sensible and still small and enough. You will never find it. That is it. Okay. Second, have your website and email done. Then block the Facebook, Instas, or Twitter and all those handles from your company's name. Once this is done, then go and go to Government of India and register a company after securing all those 4 things. Chances are in the first 4 available, government won't have any problem in giving you your company name. Correct? People do it vice versa. And then you end up in a losing lot of money. Then you know, start with your deeds, open your current accounts, acquire PAN number, TAN number, CC numbers, digital signatures. You need to register, protect. I think there are a lot of steps. No college is going to tell you in a single course. That's why I said you need mentors. So people who think economics is a bad subject, who hate economics, who hate accounts, who chose engineering because they said accounting is too boring to do. Probably this is where you need to come back and go to your basics and start learning once again, because some of these things actually need accounting knowledge. Or else your CA or CS would charge you depth of form because you don't know what to get. And you'll start losing money. So it's important you should, you know, go read how the market is going and read about MBAs, read about lawyers, make friends outside engineering also so that when needed you can consult them. Alright, this is very confidential and this is how I started off. Okay, you will see the mathematics that I did. I spent, so I have, you know, two kind of cost, non-avoidable cost which I am calling as NAs, and then I am calling it A's which are avoidable cost, and this is the incubation model that college is having. So you for website and email, keep a budget of at least 20,000. Then you will need budget for hosting the website, for all your government, DIN, PAN, TAN and GST. Do you know what is DIN? Do you know what is PAN? Do you know what is GST? So you have not run out of people doing something like this. What's the internship cost? You have to hire interns, of course you cannot afford 50,000 employees on day one, no. You don't have money. So how many of you would hire interns? What's the internship cost in PEC? 5,000, 7,000? What would you like to request a company when you go for internship? Sorry? If you are an owner of the company, how much would you like to pay? If you are an owner of the company, what internship amount can you afford to pay? For what internship amount would you ready to be get paid to get hired? As an intern, from PEC. 50,000? Okay, in internship. So these are the kind of people who will never help you start, okay? Because they ask for 50,000 internship and there will be multiple of them. So you will have to balance it out. You will understand the variety of situation. Why people from PEC are not hired by startups and they never get startup experience because you guys are too costly to hire. But when you will do startup, you will think that I'm a guru because I'm not getting, you know, people who can be interned. That's where the biggest problem is. When we have to hire interns from IITs, we need to say them. But when they will start up on their own, they now begging for small money. So, you know, it's like seeing both sides of the tables and then valuing it. If you are a job seeker, 7,500 is like what? Nothing. If you are a job giver, 7,500 is like, yaar, bahut mushkil se aaya, aa jao. Okay? Stationery, CFO, CSO, IT budgets, you will burn down and use, and then there are a lot of things with incubation centers and so on. Getting your first chairs, getting your first tables, getting the rent sorted, office modifications, putting up biometrics, buying laptops, and so on. So, all in all, I estimated that the annual running cost for a business is about 27 lakhs, of which there are avoidables, which is about 1/3 of it. But the remaining 66% of it for 1 year you cannot avoid. That's for a typical IT business that I'm suggesting. Okay? So at any given point of time, you still have to have about 5-7 lakhs ready if you want to get into business. Whom you should go to? Ask your parents कि शादी के तरह पैसे निकाले और उनको और ट्रिपल करके देंगे. Give them equity. Give them a 10% rate of interest if you start getting it back. नहीं है अगर आप कह रहे ना अपने मटेरियल के लिए इतना ही कर सकते. Because investors won't let you go. Parents can. Alright, so there will be challenges. Say, opening, you know, business, send out capital. Risk of losing your social and family life, working long hours, there will be mistakes, you will do a lot of mistakes, so many do mistakes in your startup. So all in all, this is the stats. So this is the people like you and me who started off these businesses last year and came up. I already told you our number, 3 in startups, correct? There are a lot of government schemes that are there, but companies like us are not protecting their IP. That's the typical error Indians are doing right now. Hum hard work kar rahe hain, paisa la rahe hain, jo bana rahe hain usko.